Hello everyone, Queen Miala here, back with some more Prehistoric Kingdom Closed Alpha. So today I tried to build a building for the micro raptor, but it didn't turn out how I would like it to be. So I redid, well, I deleted completely and I started with a new project that I had in mind for the Tyrannosaurus Rex habitats. So I saw that people were able to walk on these rocks, which is sometimes pretty funny, but you could do a lot of crazy things with it. So I thought maybe we can do a rock kind of bridge where people can walk over to go to another island or something like that, like walk over the water on these rocks. But I tried it out, and of course I saw that you need to have like an underground under these rocks before people would be able to walk on it. So I was a bit stupid, but I mean, I was just trying things out and it didn't work out, so I deleted it. And I started off with a bit ground with a bit of ground first before I could place these rocks. So yeah, I divided this up into two pieces of plain water and I tried out some ground types. Guys, what is new about this game? If you see at like Planet Zoo, this game has ground types for each different biome, which is so cool because normally you have just all these ground types in like in one tab and then you have to choose between these ground types. But for this game, you can choose per biome which ground types you're gonna use. So for every biome, I see five to six sometimes ground types, which is interesting. For now, they don't really blend together well. It looks a bit wonky, so I hope they will try and fix that later on. But yeah, the developers are busy. It is a an alpha state, so we know that a lot of things are gonna change, and I'm curious how they will change the ground types. But it is interesting that you have these biomes linked to these ground types. I'm curious to see how that will work out in the future. But yeah, also something else, like I said before, people can walk on builders, and we will have a moment that people will walk on these builders at a place that I don't want them to. So that's also something that I'm very curious about. I really hope that the developers will make it possible for us to select, for example, a builder and make it walkable for people instead of just now whenever a builder is right next to a path that people will walk on it, because as you are going to see in this video, people are just gonna walk on builders on places that it looks very strange. So yeah, I'm pretty well. It is a very cool thing that people can do. So I'm curious how the developers are gonna make it possible for us to choose where people are gonna walk, because yeah, otherwise it will look strange. So yeah, that's something I'm also curious about. Something else that I also want to talk about is the game is still in alpha and I know it. And this week they already did an update with like better optimized gameplay, but it's still not optimized. I mean, I still have a lot of problems with the game, as in like it goes sometimes pretty slow, especially like the movement of the people and the dinosaurs. But it's not that it isn't playable for me, but it's just too bad, because if you want to make a beautiful after movie from the build that you did and these dinosaurs are like going very slow, it's too bad. But I found a way to make it less worse, as in like this map. Sorry, the cat is asking for a lot of attention today. But this map is super big. So what you can do, for example, is delete some trees in the background because they use a lot of memory, you could say. Or like for me, it just helps with the game going a bit faster. Something else that you can do is I had some developers in my Twitch chat this week, and they said that you can delete the grass. So if you deselect or delete the grass, it will also be a bit better or running a bit smoother, as you can will see. So that's also something that I did. So those are two things that I did that you can use if your game is a bit slow. But yeah, also my PC is not the greatest thing, so I guess that's also a problem, but that's something that I cannot fix like right now. So but yeah, okay, so back to the Tyrannosaurus Rex habitat. I was building a little lookout. I think it looked very cute where the Tyrannosaurus Rex will be able to like jump on and like yeah, walk on, and it is a bit closer to the people, so people will be able to watch them a bit closer. And they use it a lot, so it's pretty fun to see that you're walking on that. Also, something else what I'm a bit struggling with is the habitats, how big they need to be. I guess that will be of course implemented in the game a bit later on, but right now you have to figure out how big you have to make these habitats, and sometimes they look way too big and sometimes they look way too small. So yeah, I have to fix that a lot of times while I'm playing the game, like make habitats way smaller than I did before. So I am curious how big these habitats has to be, because I don't know, dinosaurs are big, guys. But yeah, we picked out two Tyrannosaurus Rex. I picked a brownish one and the one with feathers because, I mean, dinosaurs with feathers are cool. But the brown one is, in my opinion, when I think about Tyrannosaurus Rex, the brown one that I picked is like the one that I see as I think when I think about Tyrannosaurus Rex. The models are so freaking cool. It's so amazing how they look like. I'm super excited to see more dinosaurs. They look amazing. The movements look amazing. And they already did some an update this week with some more movements for some dinosaurs. Also, what they did is something that I'm pretty excited about is that they made the well, whenever you build a path and the water is close by it, you had like a space between the water and the path that has to be there. But it was way too big before, and now they made it a bit smaller. So it's good to see that you can place paths like right next to water, because before you could not do that. Also with the fences, I mean, sorry, the fences. You can also put water way closer to the fences, which makes it a bit more, easy to build things like this, for example, because before we couldn't build this because the paths would be too close to the water. But yeah, I mean, I'm super excited how this will turn out to be. I hope you guys enjoy this video. And yeah, I will see you at the end of the video. Bye, everyone. Thank you. So yeah, we're at the end of the video, guys. Thank you so much for watching until here. I hope you guys enjoyed the speed build. I think the habitat looks pretty cool, in my opinion. I'm very happy with how it turned out to be. I'm curious to see what else we're going to do. Maybe I'm thinking about a beach type habitat for one of the dinosaurs, but I have to check it out first. Or maybe like build a building for the microraptors. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel. That would be appreciated. I stream every week on Twitch 3 times a week, so feel free to join over there as well. And yeah, thank you so much for hanging out. Have a lovely rest of your day. Bye everyone.